and you hear those magical words, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's the same words Jesus Christ heard as he stood in the Jordan River. He was chosen. If the greatest commandment centers around love, then what does this love look like? In 1 John 3:16, our first reading, this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers and sisters. Scripture also says, greater love than this no one has, to lay down one's life for one's friends. And that is in today's gospel. We must base our spiritual relationships on this kind of love. It's a love that gives from the heart. In the last 50 years, we have seen sweeping technological advancements. And for the past year and a half, we have placed ourselves under house arrest, or arrest in general, in front of a TV screen, cell phones, or an iPad, as we subjected ourselves to solitary confinement in fear of the unknown. Our mission here on earth, you ever think when we close our eyes and go back home to heaven? That's also the fear of the unknown. Yet technology has done little to confront the problems of loneliness and emptiness. Perhaps in no other time in human history has loneliness plagued teenagers and adults alike. The inability to make and to keep friends has become a common disease. Even among Christians, with not attending Mass and receiving the spiritual nourishment of the blood and body of Christ, has our godly friendship become a lost art. Look around. I'm not making it up. One of the first recorded sentences God ever uttered about the man whom he had created is found in the book of Genesis 2:18. It's not good for man to be alone. It is imperative that we come to know how to develop godly friendships. In fact, in the book of Proverbs, we find a true friend is more loyal than a brother. Jesus is such a friend. When sin penetrated the hearts of Adam and Eve, they not only became alienated from God, but they also became alienated from one another. And when Jesus died on the cross, he made it possible for all who believe in him to be in fellowship with God. Remember, the veil was split down the middle. And also in godly fellowship with one another, he opened it all up so you and I can share Jesus Christ and the goodness of him. But godly friendships are not found. They are made. They are built up stone by stone. They are established on biblical principles. They're not found in a laboratory or some comic book someplace. A true friend can make a world of difference as we seek to follow God and make a difference in this world. Godly friends comfort us, encourage us, and keep us on a focus on a spiritual journey back home from where we just came from not too long ago. Unfortunately, relationships today are often strained with shallowness, adversity, or selfishness. Sometimes people want to be fair-weather friends or to use a relationship for their own benefit. The Bible tells us another story with Abraham and God. Abraham was God's friend. In fact, God himself called Abraham a friend. In the book of Genesis, chapter 18, God appears to Abraham. He came in appearance of a man, but Abraham recognized that it was the Lord. That's why Abraham bowed down low on the ground in a posture of worship. Abraham invited God into his hospitality, and his servants prepared a choice tender calf. That would be verse 7, chapter 18. Abraham's mutual friendship with God was not lip service. It involved action. It involved a sincere and personal sacrifice. For when the Lord rose to leave Abraham, he said, "Shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do?" Friends share secrets. So God did not want to hide from his good friend what was about to occur. What God was about to do was no small thing. He was going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah for their incredible wickedness. Abraham, in remembering that his nephew Lot was living near Sodom, entered into a trustworthy, sincere conversation with the Lord, asking him to spare the city of, if he found 50 or 45, and all the way down to 10 righteous people. And God agreed, because Abraham was his friend. All the great works that God gives us on a daily basis, the sun rising, the nice weather, the birds singing, I can tell you that God is eager to renew his friendship with each and every one of us. God is longing for us to be in close communion with him. But to do so, friends need to spend time together. When you spend that time together, and I don't mean this, and I don't mean this, I'm talking conversation. I'm talking watching somebody when I speak to them, if their eyes are flickering or if they're turning away from me. Conversation. Talking with one another and sharing secrets. And to do this, we must be open. We must open our hearts to the Lord on a daily basis in prayer. Start talking to God like you would talk to your best friend. And you can do this by developing four simple communicative skills. And I feel that this video stuff, this computer stuff, has taken every one of those skills and stripped you from that ability to communicate. First, friends, you must make yourselves available to each other. And do not abandon each other during difficult times. We find in the book of Hebrews, "Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you." That's the basic of being a friend. Second mark of genuine friendship and communications, friends not only talk to each other, but they share their innermost feelings and listen to each other. Saintly relationships are built on a shelter in which we can be vulnerable and honest about our shortcomings and temptations. Sometimes you get hurt. And in turn, our friends will keep our confidences and encourage us in our struggles. The encouragement is the third key to true friendship. Friends are generous with their forgiveness, their praise, and their appreciation for each other. They speak kind, uplifting words to each other. When we falter, a friend will help us and walk with us towards the right path. Remember the road to Emmaus? A true friend will lovingly correct us when we wander to the wrong side of that right path. They won't be afraid to say, "Hey, I don't feel comfortable with what you're doing." And the final hallmark of genuine friendship is loyalty. True friends do not gossip, do not complain, or scheme against each other. They work together on the same team and walk together in faith. Our love for God pours out into our friendships as we love our friends sacrificially. And we see in the book of scriptures, "My command is this," and we hear it today in our gospel, "Love each other as I have loved you, for a greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for a friend." True godly friendships They don't come easy. This kind of support comes only through time and effort. We must respectfully come to share experiences with someone so as to realize a true friendship. Many times we find false friends who desert us in our most desperate times or who break our confidences. But through time and the blessing of the Holy Spirit, we are able to weed out false friends from the true ones and build fruit-bearing friendships that will last into eternity. On this weekend that we celebrate Mother's Day, on behalf of all of us, very, very happy and sacred Mother's Day to all moms and moms-to-be. And always remember, a good way to start Mother's Day is maybe praying a decade of the Rosary, 10 Hail Marys, one Our Father, for Mom, because she gave you everything. And remember our Lord Jesus Christ, because from the altar of his cross, he gave us Mary, his mother, for our friendship and our understanding. Happy Mother's Day to all. God bless.
Together now, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray that God may guide and strengthen his church and may comfort and sustain all those in need.
Our response is, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have been baptized into Christ this Easter, and for all who have received First Holy Communion and confirmation during this Easter season, we pray to the Lord. We pray for our parish family, that the people of every race and culture who seek Christ may find a welcome among us. We pray to the Lord. Joining in prayer for all who are in prison, that those who have done wrong will be converted, and the innocent set free, that all may be sustained in hope by our prayer. We pray to the Lord. Joining in prayer for the leaders of governments everywhere, that they may bring peace by seeking justice for the world's poor and upholding the rights and the dignity of all, we pray to the Lord. Praying for all the sick, especially Stephanie Gagliotti, that they may be returned to good health, we pray to the Lord. For the faithfully departed, especially Barbara Cornell and Ramona Dubois, that they may rest in peace and rise in glory, we pray to the Lord. For the intentions in our prayer intentions book, and the prayers that we keep deep within our own hearts. And for the people of this parish, we, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray with your Son that we and all people may remain in your love. We ask these things in his name, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, our God, and the glory of yours,
now and Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. This Thursday is a holy day, the Feast of the Ascension. Although not an obligation yet, masses are regular 8 a.m., 12 noon, and 7:30 p.m. We're wishing all moms a very happy Mother's Day filled with the peace and love of God. And as always, remember to take home the bulletin.
And since it is Mother's Day weekend, we do have a special blessing for mothers. Now, you heard in the first reading how the Holy Spirit went to Cornelius. He knows only to go to the right people, so don't worry. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for the blessing.
Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women, that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God. Amen.